Vinney Smile Chopra, a man who took $7 to a portfolio of over $250 million in apartment investing. He mentors and coaches to make apartment syndication easy. Each week, he will share his expertise, tricks, trades, and golden nuggets how to master the art of syndication to bring cash flow streams to your business, to change your life for the better. Here is Mr. Smiles.
Syndication made easy with Vinney Chopra, also known as Mr. Smiles. Mr. Smiles is one of the top syndication investors in the apartment syndication arena in the U.S. to date. He came to this country with only $7 in his pocket, and now I think he's worth over his portfolio is what, over $300 million now?
$300 million, yeah, 308. Something like that.
That's pretty crazy. And I know that you, you've been pretty strong, like throughout the U.S., especially this year, you've made some pretty big jumps, including he has published a number one international bestselling book, Syndication Made Easy. Go check it out. It's on Amazon. But each week I get to interview Mr. Smiles about, you know, the syndication world and the syndication business. And he is nice enough to give me the golden nuggets that his mastermind students, they pay thousands and thousands of dollars each week to, you know, we get that information for free here each week. And his students, they pay so much money to get this information. So this is going to be a great interview. And I'm actually pulling stuff right from his book, his number one international bestselling book, Syndication Made Easy. So Mr. Smiles, hello, how are you doing this week?
Hi there, Lisha. I'm really well. It's a beautiful day here in San Francisco area, right?
Yeah.
Blackhawk. I love it. It's beautiful. Oh my gosh. Just looking around, you know. I don't know if I could show. I don't want to mess up our thing.
Oh, no, it's gorgeous. Yeah, that's a good view.
From our my office and home, we are very, very happy. You know, we just moved here. So I'm ready. Yeah, what's the topic today?
So today we're going to talk about the listing path, which I'm pulling right out of your book. So I'm excited about this. I know that in a previous interview that we did, we did talk about the different types of listings.
Yeah.
But I really want to go into it in more detail, which we did talk about that in the last show, that we were going to do a second show, you know, backing up the listing. Mm-hmm. And in the book, you call it the listing path. So talk to me about this.
Surely. You know, see, the thing is, we are talking to the brokers. We are building relationships with lots of brokers in two or three emerging markets. Like I say that in the book, also, Alicia, the key thing is that we need to make sure how we get the listings from the brokers. We want to be as close to their best list as possible. What do I mean by that? See, brokers have four or five different lists of people that they give the crud. I call the crud first, because if you're the new, you know, investors and you're trying to build relationship with the broker, they're going to give you very superfluous, some very bad list, you know, listings or something that they cannot sell at all. That's the one they're going to send it to you to test you out. They're going to test you and see if you give them a feedback, or you just look at it and you say, oh my gosh, what a bad, you know, multifamily lead that the broker sent you and things like that. The biggest thing is, even though it's bad, you've got to call them back, email them back, or text them back and tell them, you know, hey, this does not fit my criteria. You know, it's got this deficiency or this deficiency or whatever. You know, it fits, the cash on cash is not that great, or the area or things like that.
I have a question. Why?
Oh, okay. The reason is, see, the brokers like to test you out, the new investors, how solid you are, first of all. Are you just wasting their time? Are you going to be really closing it, or you're just getting into, that's why I teach in the book also, you got to learn the lingo of the, you know, brokers. You say, hey, by the way, I have equity raised. Please say that, you know, and you have to raise the equity, meaning have the investors ready to jump into the deal. See, a lot of time people are saying, Alicia, that let me write up an LOI. Let me do this. Let me do underwriting. Let me do that. But I say, stop. Do you have investors who are going to bring the money to the table?
Yeah.
And if you have no investors, you need not put in any LOI. If you have not qualified for a loan, you know, and with your partner or yourself, you should not be putting an LOI. You need to start it just like my book says, get the whole sequence started in the right way, because you got to get the investors down. You got to have pre-existing relationships with the 506B. Many of you have been following me now for quite a bit of time. You got to be already in that sync. Have your LLC made, have the team made, and then have the pre-qualification and the proof of funds already secured through a lender or co-sponsor or principal. And then also you need to really now be building relationships with the investors. You cannot get a deal under contract and then look for investors. That's wrong way, and it's the SEC frowns upon it and everything. You have to have pre-existing relationship with the investors, document signed, the CRM notes all written out so that there is a curation period and all that. Okay, let's go to brokers again. So now,
so the reason why you're calling them to tell them the deal is bad is just not only tell them that you're serious and that you're doing your research, but to also clarify what you want.
Exactly. So right. True, Alicia. I mean, I cannot say, hey, I'm looking for some multifamily, you know, 8 unit or 14 unit in this area. That'll be a very bad thing. They're going to already know that you are a newbie. You're just trying to get some properties and not even know, don't have money. See, the broker's main purpose is to sell the property. Any salesperson will, right? Yeah. So you have to come up with really good, solid pitch, I call it, you know, a script or pitch to tell them, hey, Mr. So-and-so, I'm Vinney Chopra. I'm very excited about the neighborhoods of so-and-so in your MSA. You got to say that, you know, and so much is happening in this area that my partners, you have to say that. My partners are looking for some really good asset in this area in the range of 8 units to 50 units or 8 units to 20 units. You've got to give that specific number, because otherwise you are wasting their time and your time. Yeah. If you can't buy anything more than 15 units, why in the heck are you, you know, reaching out to the brokers who have 50 units and 100 and 200 units? They're not going to even give you. See, credibility is so important. That's so, so important that you don't mess up with the brokers. You know, if you mess them up, they're not going to start talking to you. And then they're going to get the word out. Hey, don't talk to that guy. He's just a waster, time waster. You know, he never replied to me and this. They all talk. They have breakfast and things like that, lunches together. So be careful, you know, what you are talking to brokers about. Build relationships and call them back or text them or email them every, I say 10 to 15 days, 10 to 15 days. If you're starting out, you got to be in the skin, you know, and send them some articles. If you found something very good happening at that branch of their, you know, whatever, you know, it's ARA or Cushman or Millichap or whatever news that came into that MSA or the submarket, you found out about it. If I were you, I'll email that news to that broker. You know what? See, the more communication you have with the broker, he's going to say, oh my gosh, that's Vinney. You're right. Yeah, he talked to me. So the more people that you are able to get, you know, people to really look at you as a different person and somebody who's not wasting their time building relationship and really have the equity raised with the investors that you can jump in, you are pre-qualified. That's the person they want to talk to, because that was my tremendous, you know, mantra, I could say, was that I want to only buy from listing brokers. Why? Because listing brokers are the ones closest to the seller on this side. and they know their temperature. They have told, asked the seller, give financials and rent rolls and everything. They're going to do a broker's price opinion, you know, or broker value of broker's opinion of value, either way, same thing. But who knows the most information about the property are the listing brokers. Do not work with, I say that, and I've done it for the last 14 years, don't work with sellers, buyers, brokers. Sometimes you may need to bring it in, but I always worked with the listing broker so that I'm right here on this side. This is the listing broker and there is the seller. So there is no vacuum. I call it, there is no vacuum. So no loss of communication. So yeah, you know, because people change the stories. I mean, you know, if you tell your buyer broker, he's got his interest, he's going to say something else to comply to this listing and all that. So in the whole scheme of things, I want to mention about this podcast, brokers have different levels of interest of the investors. So they give to the closest to them who have been performers. That's the word. They are called buyers or performers on time. They do not do retrades. That's a big word. Some of you may know about it. Some don't. What that means is you put an LOI together and then you say, hey, let me lock it up for 30 days. And then we can slip out. A lot of coaches teach that. I don't teach it. I do not teach that because that's a wrong attitude. You don't want to get locked in a property and then get out of it in 30 days. You need to do all the due diligence upfront about everything. Once you say, I'm going to put an LOI, you have the loan taken care of, the you know, all the due diligence amounts and earnest money, everything. You got to plan in a systematic way so that you close. And that's the reason, Alicia, I've closed on 27 deals, 27 deals, 100% closing record. And the brokers love me, you know, because they know, it's the contract, you know, he's going to close on it.
Well, and I love it because actually I wanted one of our next podcasts, we're going to talk about LOIs and we're going to talk about retrades and the pros and cons, but I want to get back to the listing path. So I know that brokers are dire when it comes to the multifamily business and making sure that you're stay close to the seller as you can, if it's possible. So I guess when I'm looking at your book, let's go. Like, I know we went through the different types of listings before, but let's do a brief overview of what they are and, you know, and then what type of listings that there are available, just so that we're definitely educating. And then like what to do to prior analyze a deal. So that way they know, you know, what to actually, that could be a whole nother podcast in itself. Yes. Different podcast about how to analyze a deal prior.
Totally. Oh yeah.
That was the LOI with this one. That's going to be a great month of how to get started on your multifamily business.
Totally. Totally. Alicia, also I wanted to mention to you, I know in the revelation with my travels, I've not really traveled that much in the country in 5 years, by the way. I just went out 2 weeks back to Dallas, to Houston, book signing and all that, meeting a lot of people. We had almost 558 people there in the Dallas conference. And I was so humbled, actually, how many people knew me, you know, and I really appreciated that. And they were taking pictures with me and, you know, the book signing and all, and Boston, same thing, then New York, then all the places, New Jersey. And, you know, I'm just going to be so excited to really get out there, because my thinking was, Alicia, that I don't need the money. I don't need the deal, because I have so much great contact with the brokers. They give me the pocket listings or napkin listings. Okay. And then I have the money from my investors. I can raise $7 to $10 million in a day or two, you know, so that's not hard. But I think I'm going to get out more. I just want to let everybody know in September, as this podcast is coming out or whenever, that please be there in Orlando. I'll be there with Jake and Gino, my good friends, and Dylan Marma and everybody, you know, on the stage. We are also putting some really good things right here in the Silicon Valley, right in my backyard, right in San Francisco area. I'll be there on September 26th. I think with David Green, the co-host of Bigger Pockets. You know, we are chairing, really great event with Bo Eckstein, and a lot of great speakers are going to be there. So please go ahead and come out there and meet them with, people and, get your education so that you can move into, the great world of multifamily and other businesses, So.
Sure, remind me, I have an idea about some of those events.
Yeah, let's go back to listings again. The thing is, lots of things stay in my mind quite a bit. The big thing is that, like you shared this book, it took me 2 years to write it, by the way. And, I'm so glad that people are liking it and so forth. And, we are converting it into audio, by the way.
Yeah, that should be done here in the next probably 10 days.
10 days or so. Spanish version is already back. So we are checking it, proofreading it and all. And then, we are thinking about the second book that I'm writing on positivity brings profitability. Yeah. That's exciting. That's getting the start already. But let's talk again. The podcast was about brokers, relationships, and listings.
Listings,
yeah. Things, we can also do our own different ways to get the listings also. We don't need to involve the brokers. And that is the way through texting, through email campaigns, through letter writing, directly to the, to the sellers or owners, we should call it. And I might like to bring in this podcast, something we've been going all over USA now talking about is the new company we are starting called Oxygen. Oxygen is a new company startup, which is going to be like, we'll be able to have 27 parameters that we have put together, and we'll be able to take all the different, investors or owners. And if they fall under this, all different filters, we call it, we'll pinpoint those particular multifamily in the 8 to 48 level at this time, smaller level. And then we'll be able to put together 32-page proposal to the sellers. They don't even know if they're going to be selling yet. See, so we're going to catch it even before the brokers, by the way. So we are finding that the whole system is very antiquated is the word. So we are trying to bring technology, capital partners, and syndication and everything into the arena. So what we'll be doing, we'll be able to offer them to buy the multifamily within 7 to 10 days. And they get cash for it right away. And then we'll be having that same asset ready for the syndicators and small investors like, I used to be. And there are lots of people in the country. So they'll be able to plug right in.
So based, I know exactly what you're doing. That's ninja.
Yeah.
That is ninja. I know exactly what you're doing. Ninja.
So I think it's the best way to describe is that, we are trying to, bring some new avenues, new things so that we can make it really easy for our investor base and so forth like that.
That is really, really good. I love it. I love it. We're going to have to talk about that off of the show. But let's dive back into, so let's go over the types of listings that there are.
So, yeah, Alicia, what you're talking about, what I mentioned in the book, is so true, because the thing is, every broker has about 4 or 5 different levels of listings. Okay. In other words, the very first one, I invented that, by the way, is the napkin listing. What that means is, I found when I was doing it over there in the Texas market, one broker will give me the address of the property. That's all I needed, just the address. And it was when the seller was sitting down in a napkin and writing it down, hey, we want to sell the property. It was a napkin listing, and the broker was giving me those deals right from the napkin. So that was the first level. That's something I invented. The second one is the pre-pocket listing. What does that mean? Pre-pocket is the one where investors are exposed to the deal. Only very few investors. See, what happens is every broker has a
pocket. I don't have an answer for that.
Okay. No. So essentially my series is saying, I don't have an answer, but the thing is, what is happening is that they are able to take that listing. They give it to very select people, might be five, might be six people who are very big performers. Like I come into that play now with many of the brokers, you know, so that's called the pre-pocket listing. Now comes the pocket listing. What is that? You know, that's a client list of clients where they'll be able to give it to them. See, they want to sell it themselves. Let me share with you. The brokers want to sell the property quickly. They want no retrade, and they want to give it to the people that have been performing already, and they have the gumption, the money, and all the things are all approved for them. You know what I mean? So that's the other one I talk about. And then they open it up to their office. Aha. So what that means is now they're giving from their pocket, the listing is going out to their other brokers and other people right there in their office. And then, of course, is the one office floor. They open up to all the people, you know, other brokers and things like that. And the last one is, you know, popular welcome listing reaches the entire public. And that is called what? The LoopNet, or, you know, the other platforms online. So there are different levels, as you can tell.
So, and then to talk to, so those are all the different types of listings, right?
Correct.
And so obviously the ones that you would prefer would be the napkin.
Oh my gosh, the very first one. I mean, you know, the napkin or the pocket listing is the free pocket even is the best one. So please do look into this book. It's got lots of great nuggets that it took 2 years to put together. And a lot of people are liking it. I hope you will like it too, so that, you know, we can learn a lot about what happens in the world of syndication.
Yes, and be nice to your brokers.
Yes, be nice. Very, very nice, guys. They can make and break you, really. And I love to text them. I mean, you know, a lot of my brokers, when I go to Texas, when I go to Atlanta, I go to Florida, I go ahead and text them. Same message. Hey, Vinny is coming and I really appreciate what you are doing for me. You know, if you have something in the pipeline, please let me know so that I can tour those properties, or my team can do the analysis. The biggest thing my brokers tell me, Vinny, first of all, we like working with you because you are very prompt in replying and you give me decision quickly. That's the big thing, you know, because the worst thing can happen is they send out to a lot of people their listings or whatever information, but you don't reply back. That's the worst thing, you know?
Yeah, and they're sitting there like, what's going on? And yeah, no, you're probably the perfect broker, because there you are. You're very responsive. You do make decisions quickly. You're not a waiver or somebody who does, like, you know, they sit on it. But no, I love it. So, like, I always like to end our shows with a nugget of advice. So if you, you know, if somebody was in the syndication world and you're talking about listings, what would be your number one piece of advice for syndication?
Totally. Alicia, I would say, you know, definitely look at all the avenues to get some great listings. I mean, that's the name of the game. I know it's been tougher, to be truthful. We are in the, you know, August, actually, middle of August of 2019. It's been a pretty, competitive. I think last year was very high too, 2018, but 19, it was quite a bit. We did buy one great property, 52 million. And I just toured some pocket listings, you know, right there, also more in Florida. So they are out there. Don't give up. You know, you may be that it will take you a little bit time to move in the ranks with your brokers. But please look into this whole podcast, give them good feedback and steer them. I call it steering the brokers, you know, only work with the brokers or waste their time. I shouldn't say waste, but use their time for the benefit of them and you. So the more you find out and they find out that you can close, you have the money raised and that you are a great performer and you're a closer, you will inch it up, you know. So please be kind to the brokers.
Nice. Be kind to the burgers. That should be on a shirt. You should start throwing some swag on your website. All right, guys, you just got your weekly syndication golden nugget from Mr. Smiles, Vinney Chopra. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. Also, if you guys have any questions for Mr. Smiles, please leave them in the comments. We'll be sure to answer them on the next show. And then we hope you guys have a terrific week. We do these shows every week to help, you know, Mr. Smiles wants you to bring your business to the next level. And he always says, make it happen each day. And Mr. Smiles can be found as at VinneyChopra.com, right?
Yep. VinneyChopra.com all the way. MoneelInvest.com. That's another one. Moneel Communities and all the places. But best thing is to go on the YouTube channel, Vinney Chopra, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, my academy in the group, close group also.
Got the book on Amazon.
Yes, that's right. You know, go over there. So thank you so much, Alicia. And look forward to next week.
Thanks. Awesome. All right. Thank you, Vinney. Thanks, guys. Till next week.
Be sure to listen to Mr. Smiles next week with more golden nuggets and top-notch coaching tips. You can reach him by going to VinneyChopra.com or texting the word syndication to 474747. Be sure to like, comment, and share to show everyone how Mr. Smiles has brought your apartment syndication business to the next level.